Good morning, myself is Santosh Bharati. Now last lecture I discussed about the digital delta modulation. Delta modulation is a part of digital pulse modulation, right? Today I will discuss there are two types of noise and distortions are exist in the delta modulation. One is the slow hold load distortion and next other one is the granular noise, right? So how to overcome the strobe overload distortion? Basically, to increase the strobe of staircase signal above or equals to the strobe of modulating signal, right? For this situation now, we found that the what is the minimum step size to overcome the strobe overload distortion? What is the maximum amplitude which are used to minimize or eliminate the strobe overload distortion? And what is the minimum sampling frequency which are used to minimize the slope hold of distortion? Today I will discuss about what is the signal to noise ratio of the delta modulation. Now I am going to discuss about the signal to noise ratio of the delta modulation, right? Basically, for example, suppose xt is the AM sin omega mt or AM sin 2 pi fmt to avoid the slope overload distortion. Now, slope of staircase approximation is greater than or equals to the slope of xt signal, right? Suppose this is the, for example, this is the xt. And this is the X cap T. X cap T is the staircase signal. X cap T is staircase approximated signal, and this is the modulating signal. Modulating signal are input signal, and this is the step size. And these are the step size which are the fixed. If we keep the step size fixed, now there are two types of noises are present or exist in the delta modulation, that is known as slope overload distortion. Basically this area, this region, this is slope overload distortion, and here the granular noise. Granular noise, when demodulate, now this kind of signal, while this is the small variation, small slowly varying AC signal, but at the demodulator we will find the DC signal, because this is the square wave pulses and the decoder we find the only straight line. Straight line has a DC signal, while we transmitted the AC signal. So this kind of noise is known as the granular noise, while from here to here, now this is the slope overload distortion. Slope overload means, now the slope of this staircase signal, delta modulated signal, do not follow the slope of the actual signal. So for this situation, we will not find the same signal at the receiver side. Then how to minimize the slope overload distortions? By assuming the slope of staircase approximation is greater than or equal to maximum slope of the XT signal. For example, suppose XT is the AM sin 2 pi fmt. Well, find the slope of this xt d upon dt. Xt, this is equals to am cos 2 pi fmt into d by dt 2 pi fmt. This is equals to am 2 pi fm cos 2 pi fmt. When we find the maximum value of this slope, now this is equal to am 2 pi fm. Here 2 pi fm. Similarly, this is the time interval. Now you can see here, this is the ts, This is the next year. When you find the slope of this, slope of staircase signal, I mean this is equal to step size is delta upon TS delta. TS delta. By substituting the value here, delta upon TS delta is greater than or equal to now 2 pi fm here. From here, we will get what is the minimum step size to eliminate the slope over root distances. Now this is equal to 2 pi fm am upon into TS delta. Now T, we know that now this TS delta equals to 1 by fs delta. 1 by fs delta, where fs delta is minimum sampling frequency for the delta modulation, which is almost 3 or 4 times the sampling frequency used in the PCM system. Right? So from this assumption, now we will find the minimum step size, maximum amplitude of the signal, what should be the maximum modulating frequency to eliminate the slope over load distance. So this is the conditions to eliminate the slope over load distortion. By using same conditions, now we find the signal power to the noise power. So how to calculate the signal power and the noise power? Here, now we know that in PCM system, we know that in delta modulation system, if EMTS is positive, now it add plus step size, add plus delta step size and denoted by P1. If the difference of actual signal to the approximated signal is negative, now it subtract 1 step size and denoted by the bit 0. Clear? Denoted by the bit 0. Basically, now this part is quantized by 1 bit quantizer or this is the hard limiter. Hard limiter means, now you can represent this is like this. Minus delta plus delta. So this is the output of the maximum, suppose this is the maximum step size, this is equal to 2 delta. This is equal to 2 delta, right? Now, calculate the noise power. Noise power in PCM system, basically in PCM, system, this is F del square by del square by 1. But in delta modulation, this noise power equals to del square by 1. Now we know that del equals to 2 step size, 2 delta square upon 12. That is, this is equal to 4 delta square by 12, or this is equal to delta square by 3. This is the noise power of the delta modulator before the low pass filter, before the reception. Right? Then we have to calculate the signal power. Now, you know that xt is am sin 2 pi fm t. How to calculate the power of xt? Power of xt, basically this is p max. This p max equals to how much? Vrms whole square. Because how to calculate the power of AC signal? Now Vrms whole square. Now Vrms is amplitude upon root 2 whole square. This is Am upon root 2 whole square. Or this is equal to AM square upon 2.
So this is the maximum signal power. This is the maximum signal power. Now we know that from the last slide, how to calculate the maximum amplitude? The maximum amplitude should be delta fs delta upon 2 pi fm. Substitute the value here. AM, the value of is the 1 by 2. AM is delta fs delta upon 2 pi fm whole square. Right? Fm whole square. So substitute, this is delta square fs delta square upon 2 2s are 4, 4 8 pi square fm square. So this is the maximum power now we can also write, because we know that fs delta equals to ts delta. So this is equals to delta square upon 8 pi square fm square into ts delta square. So this is the maximum power of the delta modulated signal. Yeah? Similarly we can calculate the noise power, quantization noise power at the receiver. Basically, in delta modulation, NQ is delta square by 3. But we have to calculate the output quantization noise power, right? Output quantization noise power. Now, we know that we assume that the power spectral density of the error signal is flat. We assume that power spectral density of the error signal is uniformly distributed or flat distribution over the entire band of minus 1 by Ts delta to plus 1 by Ts delta, where we know that Ts delta equals to Fs delta, or this is equals to minus Fs delta to plus Fs delta. So this is the power spectral density. This is the power spectral density of the, power spectral density of the error signal, which is flat over the entire band of the minus fs delta to fs delta, or minus 1 by ts delta to plus 1 by ts delta. How to calculate now this magnitude? So this is the magnitude, which is 1 upon 1 by ts delta minus 1 by ts delta. So this is equals to 1 upon fs delta minus fs delta, or this is 1 upon 2 fs delta. This is the amplitude of the error signal. This is the power spectral density of the error signal, whose amplitude is how much? 1 upon 2 fs delta. Right? This is the 0, 0 means at the origin, at the frequency 0, now it represents the DC amplitude. Yeah? Now we have to calculate at the demodulator of the, at the receiver of the demodulator. Now the received demodulated signal is passing through a low pass filter. Low pass filter whose frequency is either it is exactly same as the bandwidth of the message signal, or bandwidth of the modulating signal, or different, or minorly, are slowly different to the message signal or modulating signal. For example, suppose minus F capital M, F plus capital M, this represent the low pass filter. This is the filter response of the low pass filter. Here, is the filter response of the low pass filter. Then what is now? Now at the output of low pass filter, power spectral density at low pass filter, whose the bandwidth of low pass filter is F capital M. Then now what is the basically this amplitude of this signal? So this amplitude is how much? This is 2 F capital M upon 2 Fs delta. Right? Now we have to, this is the spectrum of the DMR related signal which is varying from minus Fs delta to Fs delta. But when this spectrum is passes through the low pass filter, only this part of signal is passes and remaining signal is stopped by the low pass filter. Clear? Then we have to calculate the noise power for this NQ out. Noise power at the output of low pass filter. Basically this noise power at the output of low pass filter, basically this is equals to NQ out equals to NQ into now amplitude of this signal from minus FM to plus FM. So this is 2 F capital M upon 2 Fs delta, where you to cancel out. Now substitute the value of NQ. NQ is delta square by 3. So this is del square by 3 into F capital M into Fs delta. Yeah. So this is the basically output quantization noise ratio. Now substituting the maximum power of the signal to the output quantization noise ratio in the signal to noise ratio, we will find the signal to noise ratio. Right? So by substituting the value here, by substituting the value of now this signal to noise ratio, this is the maximum signal power to the quantization noise power at the output of low pass filter. The maximum signal power is basically del square fs delta whole square upon 8 pi square fm square. This is the maximum signal power divided by quantization noise power. This is the delta square F capital M upon 3 Fs delta. Right? So this Fs delta goes upper side. Now this is delta square is cancelled by delta square and 3 goes up. Now this is 3 upon 8 pi square, 3 upon 8 pi square into Fs delta q upon F capital M into Fm square, where F capital M is the bandwidth of low pass filter and F small m is the bandwidth of the modulating signal or message signal. Clear? So this is the signal to noise ratio. Now you can see from this formula, where the message signal bandwidth is not same as the low pass filter bandwidth. If it is same, message signal bandwidth is exactly same as the low pass filter bandwidth. Now this FM equals to this FM. Now this is the FMQ. Now this is 3 upon 8 pi square Fs delta upon 0 F capital M not equals to FM, and this is F capital M is equals to FM. So these are the signal to noise ratio of the delta modulated signal, where FM is the cutoff frequency of low pass filter and Fs delta is the 3 or 4 times of the sampling frequency used in the PCM system. Clear? So this is the basically deep description of the delta modulation. Now I am going to discuss about the cutoff to delta modulation. in adaptive delta modulation, why it is called adaptive? There are two drawbacks of the delta modulation. There are two types of noise or distortion exist in the delta modulation when we get the fixed step size of the delta modulation. Clear? If the signal largely varying signal, if we get the fixed step size, now the slope of the staircase signal do not follow the slope of the modulating signal. Now this causes the error, this causes the distortion known as slope overload distortion. But if signal input signal varying slowly and keeping the fixed step size, now at the demodulated side, at the receiver side, now we received at the DC signal while we transmit at the AC signal. Now this noise is known as the granular noise. So these two noise is overcome by using the adaptive delta modulation. Now you can say basically for this input signal, if the signal variation is large, now keeping the large step size, you can see here large step size. If the signal varying slowly, now keeping the small step size. So by choosing the variable step size, now we can minimize or we can eliminate the noises exist in the delta modulation. Now this situation is known as adaptive delta modulation, right? You can say this is the step size for this, and this is again step size. This is again step size. You can see this is the variable step size. If signal varying slowly, now we keep the small step size. If signal varying largely, now we keep the large step size. By doing this, now we can minimize the, we can remove the noises present in the delta modulation. Now this situation is known as adaptive delta modulation, right? Adaptive delta modulation. So now next slide, now you can see same situation and the how to change the step size according to the variations of the input signal. So we use the algorithm. The algorithm used for adaptive delta modulation with step size increase or decrease of 50% is depend upon the signal variation. If signal largely varying, now increase the step size. If signal slowly varying, now decrease the step size. So this is the delta k between the variable step size. This is equal to delta k minus 1 into x cube k plus 0.5 x cube k minus 1 upon x cube k. If the previous step size is greater than or equals to minimum step size. Minimum step size basically calculated from the to avoid the slope overload distortion. And if this is less than minimum step size, now this is equal to minimum step size. Clear? So this algorithm are used to remove the step size. I mean to remove the noises present in the delta modulation. Now come to the block diagram which are used for the, now this is the block diagram which are used to increase or decrease the step size. So basically this part, from here to here, this is similar to delta modulation. And this part, this is used for the to control the step size control. This is block diagram used to step size control or the logic controls, which control the step size if signal input signal varying largely. Now increase the step size. If signal input signal varying slowly, now decrease the step size. Right? So this is used for the and other mathematical descriptions are similar to delta modulation. There is no only difference. Difference only to control the step size. And similarly, now this is again similar to the delta modulation. From here to here, DM receiver, and this block is are used to control the step size. So these are the block diagram of the adaptive delta modulation and delta modulation. Now I am going to discuss about the advantages of the adaptive delta modulation with the delta modulation. Now you can see here, you can see In adaptive delta modulation, now signal to rise as you become better than the ordinary delta modulation, because here the precise control of the step size. Precise control means there is no noise exists in the delta modulation. If no noise exists in delta modulation, means noise power is minimum. Noise power minimum is signal to noise ratio is maximum. Yeah, the signal to noise ratio become better than the ordinary delta modulation because of the reduction in the slope overload distortion and the ideal noise and the slope granular noise. Second advantage, the dynamic range of the adaptive delta modulation is wider than the delta modulation because of the variable step size. Because of the variable step size, now the dynamic range of the adaptive delta modulation is increases compared with the delta modulation. And last one, the utilization of the bandwidth of adaptive delta modulation is better than the utilization of the channel bandwidth of the delta modulation. Okay? So these are the major advantages of the adaptive delta modulation with the delta modulation. Now I am going to discuss about the comparison between the pulse mode modulation, delta modulation and DPC modulation. So you can see in terms of the number of bits in PCM signal, now individual samples is denoted by either 4-bit, 8-bit or 16-bit per sample, but in delta modulation uses only 1-bit per sample. Similarly, in DPCM now bit rate reduced by the 50% in the PCM system. If it is denoted by 4-bit, 8-bit or 16-bit, in DPCM this is a 2-bit, 4-bit and 8-bit. Yeah, because in DPCM the bit rate is reduced by the 50%. Right? Similarly, the label and step size. The number of labels depend upon the number of bits and label size is kept. Label size and step size is kept in the PCM system, and delta modulation again step size is fixed, but there are two types of distortion is introduced, and here the fixed number of label are used. Similarly, third point, quantization error and the distortion. In PCM system, the quantization error exists while keeping the step size is fixed. In delta modulation, when keeping the step size is fixed, there are two types of noises present, slope overload distortion and the granular noise. But in DPCM system, again slope overload distortion and the quantization noise is present. And fourth point is transmission bandwidth. The highest bandwidth required since number of bits are high, because the bandwidth is half of the bit rate. More number of bits are used to obtain the individual sample, the more number of the bit rate. If bit rate is high, now required bandwidth is high. Similarly, in the every sample is denoted by a single bit, the required bandwidth requires the lowest bandwidth for the transmission of the same signal. Similarly, in DPCM, the half of the bandwidth of the PCM signal is required to transmit the same signal using the DPCM signal. Right? And last point is the feedback. There is no feedback is required in the transmitter and receiver, but in delta modulation of feedback is required. Again, DPCM is also the feedback is required. So these are the comparison between pulse mode modulation, delta modulation and adaptive delta modulation. Right? Now I am going to discuss the next topic in the delta modulation, which is known as line coding. Right? So basically in line coding,